Hello everybody, this is Theron. Welcome to Minecraft LAN Party, Season 2. This is a village that we found. Hey dude, where do you think you're going? What's your name, Mr. Cleric? Yeah, look at this. We have a little village. We're about 3,000 blocks. Oops. Yeah. That was bound to be embarrassing. Whoa, there we go. We're about 3,000 blocks out from spawn. And I stumbled across this place out adventuring, looking for stuff, looking for biomes and whatnot, and looking for pumpkins in particular, I believe. So I built a portal out here. It's about 3,000 blocks out. Oops. Let's switch to the correct tool. Hello, dude. And I found this guy. Huh. He's a librarian. He's got a mending book for 14 emeralds. Hi. How are you? I had him in a similar enclosure over there. And he escaped or he was killed. I'm not entirely... Oh, Cleric was communing with the chicken. So this was pretty cool. 14 emeralds is a pretty good price. So I was able to put mending on a few things, like my sword and stuff, which is awesome. Village is doing okay over here. I was thinking I might want to build up a little villager breeder sort of system over here, make an artificial village or something. And start collecting guys, and I may still do that. However, let me show you something. So, yeah, I built a portal out over here because we're about 3,000 blocks out, but by Nether, of course, it's only about 300 some. Yeah, that's loud. So I dug a tunnel out here because it was pretty much all through Netherrack. And to make a slightly more convenient access, which is cool. There's one little spot that goes out through unprotected space. Have to be a little careful here. No gas flying around. Gravel just sitting there floating, which shouldn't happen, but you know. Oh, there's a gas. I hear one. Okay. Boom. Now we're safe. So, working on this, trying to come up with a scheme, working on a tunnel. It's going slow going, but it's a nice little Zen activity for when watching bad TV or whatever. So, here's the tunnel. It looks pretty familiar, probably. Not too much. I don't think this has changed too much. That leads out to the Nether Fortress. This goes to the main sort of community area, and this goes out to my base. So it's not too far by Nether. So let's go back. Okay, so whoa. Okay, thank you. All right, so I made some changes over at the villager, zombie villager purifier center. So I'll head over there and I'll make you watch the whole journey. So I'll be back with you in a moment. All right, so here we are. Zombie, just a normal zombie inside the spawner cage. I'm in the zombie spawner here, which you've seen. The zombie inside there does change, and it seems like it changes with some regularity. Not entirely sure what causes it. Certainly logging out and logging back in, and it seems to essentially spawn a small zombie and place it inside there. So it can be a zombie villager, it can be a zombie with armor, it can be a regular zombie. There's a variety of things. I've never seen a baby or a chicken jockey, or Yeah, I guess you would call it chicken jockey. Anyway, I've never seen any of those, but you never know. And it seems like even logging out doesn't do it. Now, it may just be me, but it seems like the type of zombie that's shown there seems to impact the type of zombies that come out. So when it's a zombie villager, it seems to spew out much more than 5% zombie villagers. Huh. So you see, I've collected a few more zombie villagers and converted them into zombies. So let me show you. I've got a few librarian guys. I've got one here. He's got a Fortune 3 book, not too bad. Got a couple clerics here with halfway decent trades. Let's go over here. This guy's got an infinity bow for 17, which is a good price. This guy. 22 emerald mending book. Which means I don't have to travel through the nether 3,000 blocks away to get a mending book. It's a little more expensive here, but I can do it. So I've got mending on like all the stuff. I've got mending on my helmet. I've got mending on my pants. I've got mending on my picks, on my axe, on my bow, on my sword. So I'm working on my boots right now, trying to build up a pair of boots. I'm wearing just cast off zombie armor because that thing gives me a lot of it. This guy has a punch 2, which I might go and put on my bow. I don't know. And this guy has a looting 2, which isn't great. It would be nice if we're looting 3, but I already had looting 2 on here, so I was able to get looting 3. So this is a sharpness 5, looting 3, knockback 2, mending sword, which is pretty awesome. Yeah, so I've got a collection of zombies, villagers here. There's a lot of gold tied up in this, right? So it's gotten to a point where basically I don't need any more Fletchers. I've got a farmer. Where's my farmer? Here's my farmer. Hey, dude. So I got a farmer so I can get rid of all my farm stuff. And I've got enough librarians. So I planted a few little farm type things here. I've got a little sugarcane farm. I've got some pumpkins. And I've got carrots and potatoes. And I've got chickens. Cluck, 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 cluck. Yeah, so I've got chickens jammed in there. They lay eggs. And I do this. And it spits out the eggs. And I get little baby chickens. And then when they grow up, I go kill them. Nothing's automated here. Nothing even close. I'm trying to decorate the wall a little bit using diorite and andesite, the polished varieties, which I like. I want to put some glowstone in here because the clerics, I have a pretty good supply of glowstone. I'm hanging these things up, and when I do up the ceiling, I will probably put something in to make these look like fence posts or something to make these look like they're hanging as opposed to just floating in the air. But it gives enough light between the jack-o'-lanterns. There's a jack-o'-lantern under water under here, under this carpet. And I've got jack-o'-lanterns in each of these. And I've got jack-o'-lanterns in each of these. And we don't have a good source of wool because the little sheep area that Netslayer set up, it doesn't have enough grass. It's indoor and there's not enough grass, and the sheep eat all the grass, and then they don't they can't regrow any of their fur, any of their wool. So that's a bit of a pain. Hang on a second. Oh, little whippersnapper. Ah. So anyway, I have a little process here. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, so this is a little light switch here. Turn off the lights, wait till some things spawn, and then I come here, and if they come over to me, I just kill them from here. some of them can hit me through or past the fence, the gate. Whoa. Thank you. With the knockback, the experience goes flying, so I need to come in here and pick it up. And you probably saw I have a bit of server lag going on. Notice my pings are pretty good. And I'll tell you what happened. I need to get faster internet. We have DSL from Earthlink. We've had it for a long time and it's super slow because we live in an area where the phone networks are, we're just a little too far from a switching office. So we can't get sort of, you know, good, like high speed DSL. And the only AT&T U-verse that they offer out here is DSL. They don't offer the fiber. And Verizon doesn't serve this neighborhood, so we can't get Fios. So on a good day, we get something in the neighborhood of 1.7, 1.8 megabits down, which sucks, right? That's like T1 speed, or it's a little bit better, but you know, 15 years ago, that was great. Getting that in the home would have been a dream. But today, no, doesn't work so well. And you've seen we get lots of issues when both Chihuahua Powered G and I are trying to be on a server at the same time. So I'm still getting some lag here, but it's not the same sort of lag. It's not the ping lag. Because what I did... Hello, chickens. Turn this off. So they all grow up at the same time. What I did was I swapped out our router. I was using a Netgear router, and it was a pretty decent router, but it was a little bit on the old side. It was like Wi-Fi 802.11n. It was not an AC router. And we swapped out a router that was even older, an older BG router at work with one of the latest 802.11 AC routers, and it made a gargantuan difference. It made a difference out to the internet simply because the ping times to the router were so much faster. So I figured, well, you know, going from N to AC isn't that big of a leap. It's certainly not as big of a leap as going from a G router to an AC router. And if none of this means anything to you, I apologize. I don't want to be boring you. But so I decided, I did a little research, and I got the Linksys WRT1900 AC router, which is, you know, it's a couple hundred bucks. But it was like the model up from what the one we got at work, and it was actually I really enjoyed the one we got at work. It the setup on it was really nice. I mean, I installed OpenWRT firmware on it, and it was super easy to do and set up, and the thing is blazing fast. So I did that, and I only got it set up yesterday, and I tell you, my pings have been vastly improved because our ping time out to servers on the internet is like it's like an order of magnitude faster than it used to be. And that seems to be making a significant difference for a lot of the connection lag, this, you know, the ping lag that we were getting. Have not yet. Oops. Don't throw those away. I have not yet tested this with both G and I on a server at the same time, on like the Chihuahua Land server. But we'll do that soon enough. Probably on Wednesday. A couple days from now. Not that that matters. Today is Monday the 11th, I think. Let me just check. Yeah, today's Monday, April 11th. I still have 4 episodes that have already been edited and are ready to go that I need to upload. And I will probably do another one this week. And I've been trying to pace it out a little bit. So we will, I don't want to just go post everything super quickly and then not have material to sort of follow it up with. So that's why I'm recording this right now. And then hopefully we'll record something with G later in the week. And if that all works, then, you know, then I can post a couple more things this week, at least one or two more. And then I can try and follow them up fairly quickly. But I sort of thinking long term, because there's going to be a couple things coming up where I will have a bit of a gap in terms of being able to record. So that's why I may tell you what day it is when I'm recording. It doesn't mean you're going to see it that day or the next day even. So I don't know why I bother saying. One thing I will tell you is that this Sunday, which is I think the 19th, I will be walking in MS Walk, or Walk MS, which is put on by the National MS Society. It's a fundraising walk for their programs, which support people with MS and research into MS. MS being multiple sclerosis, which I've mentioned in the past. I was diagnosed with MS about 4 years ago. It's not super rare, but it's a relatively rare autoimmune disease, and affects motor function and vision and hearing and all that good stuff. I'm doing pretty well, fortunately. But it's a good chance it's an incurable disease, and what happens is the body's immune system goes and attacks the lining of nerves in the brain and spinal cord, and the lining is necessary for function. So when you don't have good, healthy myelin lining, it's called myelin, you don't have good, healthy that, then the nerve can't conduct electricity in the normal manner. And there's a huge range, depending on where in the brain or on the spinal cord, the lesions that are created appear. You can get a wide variety of symptoms. Common symptoms are people feel dizzy or lightheaded, have difficulty talking. When I was diagnosed, I was having, I had a flare up where I was having trouble talking. It felt like my tongue was too big for my mouth, like my tongue was literally swollen up. And I had to really concentrate on talking. And I was getting lightheaded when I stood up. And after the treatment, it takes a while for things to go back to normal. If they do, they don't for everybody. There are forms of the disease that are called progressive, where things just progressively get worse and worse. The other big thing is I went blind, or I went half blind. I lost sight in one of my eyes, which was no fun. And after treatment, after diagnosis, and after treatment, I spent a week in the hospital getting pumped full of very heavy-duty steroids, which is no fun in its own. I was laying in bed feeling all dizzy, like the room was like spinning around me. And so I got up and decided I needed to do something. So I went and looked up the National MS Society, knowing that they were the primary support group for people with MS. And they had a, I saw that they had a walk that was coming up. It was a 5K walk. And so I signed up. And this will be my fifth MS, or walk MS. The timing was such that, although I was only diagnosed 4 years ago, the timing was such that the walk was coming up right away. So I went in and did the walk. I'm fortunately healthy enough that I'm doing well enough that I can walk 5,000 meters. So that was my thing. I just wanted to do it because I could, basically. Not that there's a lot of people who can't. So I'm doing it again. And in the past, I've mostly just done it because I just to do something to feel like I was, you know, actually doing something to help my situation. And I haven't really done any fundraising. You know, I kicked in a little bit of money myself, but that wasn't really what I was trying to do. This year, I actually decided to try and raise some money. Oh, hang on a sec. Oh, sorry about that. So as I was saying, in the past, I haven't really attempted to do any fundraising. And so this year, I decided that I wanted to. I wanted to actually try and help out and help maybe sort of foster a cure and help support people who are suffering from MS worse than I am. So I went and signed up, and they actually posted some online tools, which was nice. Let's see, it butchers down over here. They posted some online tools to make it easy, which was one nice thing that I saw. You know, like when Kurt J. Mack does his Farlands or Bust fundraising, he does it for Child's Play charity, and they have great online tools, which is awesome. And I was always just kind of moaning about the fact that National MS Society doesn't have similar tools, but this year they kind of do, which is awesome. So I went and signed up and set up that, and I set up a page. Now, by the time this video gets posted, I will have already done the walk, but the fundraising deadline is not done until like June. So if you wanted to go and help contribute to a good cause and support me in my fundraising efforts to help the National MS Society, I will put a link to the fundraising page in the video. Oh, hello. Why are you all locked up? Oh, I'm gonna have to fix that. I'll put a link to that in the video description. And if you want to help out, I would appreciate it greatly. Of course, there's no obligation whatsoever, but as I said, I would appreciate it. So I'll put that link down in the video description, and I'll go and put it in a few of the other video descriptions of stuff that I'm posting, that I've posted recently. So I don't know if I have anything else to talk about. As you can see, I've got a little setup here. It works. I've filled up all my little villager carols. And I don't know what I'm going to do, whether I extend this out this way and just put more in, or if I go and kill some of these guys. Like I've got the shepherd's useful. This weaponsmith, for example. Sharpness 1 diamond sword. Ooh. Probably don't need this guy. I can probably kill him. Fisherman. I've got a Fletcher as well. I don't need both. His fishing pole is luck of the sea one. Ooh. Although I think one of these guys has a lure book. Infinity. One of these guys, I think, has a lure book. I don't know that I put it. Oh, lure tour for 30, which is not super awesome. But, you know, it's an option. So I can probably clean this up a little bit. I have a bunch of clerics. I don't need a bunch of clerics. Some of them are better on some stuff than others. I don't care about the bottles of enchanting so much, but being able to get maximum glowstone and cheapest ender pearls would be nice, because I'm going to need them. And they're the primary with the zombie flesh that I get out of the spawner. They are the primary way that I raise emeralds. So anyway, and then these guys are good, but I may want to expand this. I'm thinking expand back this way, so I can put another three things over here. Plus, I have space for another one here. I don't have a whole lot of space this direction, because if we go over here, you'll see that it's just more running the cave. I could sort of build this out a bit, and I think I might, instead of doing here where I go up over here and then out over here, then down there, I may just build a walkway that just cuts that bit. I may build a tunnel that cuts through all of this at this height. This is what I've searched. Hello, dude. Hello, Mr. Slime. Ah, come here. Oh, I have a looting three sword now. So let's see what we can do, huh? Yeah. One of the problems with this, some part of this over here being a slime chunk, is they can trample the plants, which is not good. Nice. Now I have my 22 levels. I got 35 slime balls out of that. It's pretty cool. So yeah, I've got some slime. I don't have as much as I would like to make. So this is all the slime blocks that I have. I don't have enough to make like a big automated sugarcane farm or anything like that, or a gold farm. I don't have that much yet, but we're getting there. Just yesterday, I only had about 30. Oh, hey guys, you're not all quite big yet. Give you a little bit more time to all grow up, and I'll kill you all. So yeah, I get slimes inside the spawner area here, and I also get slimes up here, because it's three blocks tall. I could probably put in a lower ceiling and prevent the big ones from spawning up there. And I get some spawning like back over here. So I have a feeling that this is a chunk here and this is a slime chunk. I'm not quite sure what to do about that. But anyway, as long as they don't trample the pumpkin plants, I think it'll be fine. So anyway, I've just been grinding emeralds so that I can get plenty of mending books and upgrade some of my stuff. So I've got a pretty good sword. I talked about I'd like to get sharpness 5, but not there yet. I've got good picks. My bow is pretty good. Power 5 would be nice. So we'll work on that. And I've been off mining, and we're getting closer to being ready to head off and start farming wither skulls and thinking about trying to get some beacons. And then there's the end. But we'll see, and we'll see with if some of the other folks on the server are interested in doing like a group dragon fight. It certainly seems a lot easier when you have help. But so anyway, that's kind of what I've been up to. I've been working out in this area a lot, and now that I have a good mending silk touch pick, I may tear down this wall and dig out another. So I've been putting in this sort of, I don't have the right gap around this, which is going to drive me nuts, but it's the way it is. So I may just dig out another 11 or 12, 13 blocks out that way, I think, which is a lot of digging, but again, it's good to do when you're watching bad TV. And yeah, and I need to grind up some more wool from the shepherd. He has a one emerald for two light blue, which should work. Do a couple of those and get three carpet out of it. It's not awesome, but so I may go and do a actual sheep farm somewhere. It may be, I don't know if there's a way I can get a sheep down here and make a little sheep farm area and make it so that there's grass outside of the pen that they can't eat. So it keeps replenishing the grass so they can keep regrowing their wool. So I don't know, we'll see. So let's see here. I've got boots here, unbreaking for 22 levels, or yeah, you know what I mean, fire protection, but they're feather falling 4. That's freaking awesome. So what have I got here? I got depth strider 3, feather falling 3. Oh, I don't even need these anymore. So what's that going to cost me to combine? So if I do this, so I get my protection 18. So this gets me protection 3, depth strider 3, feather falling 4, and unbreaking 3. Okay. And let's go get some emeralds. I think I need a little more than that. Get a book. Huh. What miscellaneous books do I have here? That could be useful. Okay, cool. So we can get protection 4 with feather falling 4. Oops. Hello. 22. Huh? Hi, dude. Oh, 22. Perfectly enough. Huh. Thank you. All right, so I probably need some more levels to make this all work, but like, should I combine these? What's that gonna cost? 2, 3, let's do it this way. 2, and then should I do that? That'll cost 8, or do I combine that? 18. Oh, and I don't want to do it this way, even though it's cheaper, because I don't want fire protection boots. So I can do this. I can put the mending and make these protection 4, depth strider 3 mending. And then what's this going to cost me? 20. I can do that. 20 is relatively easy. And then there'll be protection 4, depth strider 3 mending, feather falling 4, unbreaking 3. That's a pretty good pair of boots. And I don't even really need this guy anymore. Except maybe to build up another pair of boots at some point in the future. Cool. So, you obviously don't need to watch me grinding the levels needed to make that happen. So, I will leave you there. But, thought you might like to see that update and see what's going on here. I've got a nice little area here. And honestly, with the nether portal in my base, and I might put another portal in here, If I can make it work out without being too close, I don't know if it'll link up to a new spot in the Nether or not. I have to work that out. And I also want to see, I think over here is underneath that little sand island outside the dock in my place. So I might be able to make a stairwell up here to go out to that little island to make a little bit slightly easier access. I don't know if that is easier enough to make it worthwhile. So I've got a few things to do yet. And as I get more slime blocks, I will probably try to automate some of this. Like the sugar cane, I can automate that. There are things I can do. Lag. I'm sorry. I started talking about this and didn't finish. I am getting some weird lag. Let's spawn a couple zombies and it'll make it easiest to see. Oh, thank you. That was quick. Hey, dude. So if I come here and smack them, ow! Sometimes when I hit them, they'll pop back and then they'll kind of pause for a little bit. Not happening now. Or they'll kind of freeze up and then jump at me really quick. And then hit me before, you know, when I should have hit them first. And I don't think it's pings. I think it's the server getting bogged down. And I suspect, hang on a second, let me take care of this guy. There we go. I suspect it has something to do with this. Oops. Oh, it's not too bad right now. See, the entity count. There's 129 entities loaded in the world. And when I get that sort of server lag, that number is somewhere between 180 and 210. That's kind of the range that I've seen. And it seems like if I have too many chickens bred up over here, that contributes to it. And so I try not to let these guys just go all the time. And come on. Thank you. Because that brought that down to 65. So all those guys and their eggs were each counting as an entity, which puts a little bit of stress on the server. You would think it would be able to handle that much, but apparently not. So I have a feeling the entity count numbers don't entirely make sense. Oh, stop that. Don't entirely make sense based on what I have around here. I still need to combine those. So I have a feeling there are some caves nearby that need to be lit up, and they probably at times, and maybe there's another spawner nearby. So at times, it seems like there's a fair number of mobs roaming around in caves nearby. So I'm thinking if I dig out here a little bit, that may expose some of those. And if I dig out this way a little bit, that may expose some over there. And I need to pretty up this floor and put in, I want to half slab all of it, which should prevent some of the slime spawning. So there's still a lot of work to do. I've got like cave up here that doesn't, dead ends, doesn't go anywhere. And there may be caves above me. And if I find a good spot to dig a stairwell up here, that may find me some caves too. So I need to do some cave exploration and see if I can fix some of the server performance issues. So swapping out the router definitely seemed to help though. So I think we're happy. So in probably in a couple nights, Chihuahua Power G and I will go out and work on her pixel art a little bit, and I need to drag her back into the Nether, show her and you guys, the Nether Hub that I started there. So got a little bit of stuff planned, and that will be a good test to see if how much of an improvement the router by itself made to our network troubles. And then I need to contact Time Warner Cable. Unfortunately, they're the cable operator around here, and I need to see if they can get me a high-speed cable modem and double check to make sure Verizon still doesn't serve Fios in this area. So that's kind of my homework. But we'll see. I'll have to work on that later this week. But we seem to have improved the situation tremendously just by swapping out the router, which is kind of cool. It was a little pricey. You can buy access points cheaper than $200. But if it improves our internet activity much, it'll have been well worth the cost. So anyway, leave it there. I need to raise some more levels so I can combine these boots and see if I can find myself some more librarians and work on that nether tunnel, because it's a little ugly at the moment. But anyway, that's that. So, I've been trying to sign off now for several minutes, but I think that's it. Thank you for watching. Oh, I killed him in 2 hits. That was cool. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. All right, bye.